Hey everyone, Forging Station here. If you have not already noticed, I have been using entities.foreach to iterate over entities in almost all the projects so far. Turns out there are other ways to do the same. Today we are going to see how to use iJob entity batch in a system and see if it improves the performance of our system. I am going to repurpose the void system I made a while ago. It's a pretty simple project. Let's create a spawner, component data and system, copy the code from GitHub repo. I am running Hybrid Renderer v2 here. The code works in Hybrid Renderer v1. However, if we try to do the same thing here in v2 by creating a prefab and exporting it as a mesh, then assigning the void mesh and material, well, it does not work that way. This is because Hybrid Renderer v2 has lot of other material specific components attached to rendered entities. We are hence better off converting the entities using game object conversion settings. This way, the entities are properly converted with all the components necessary for Hybrid Renderer v2 to render the entities properly. There are ways to reference a prefab and not have game object in the scene before starting the void simulation, but we are going to take an easy way out here. We are going to convert the game object to an entity and instantiate it any number of times we want. We will also assign our void component data to the first converted entity as well, just so it does not sit there doing nothing. Now if we set the parameter values that I know works well and hit play, we are going to get void simulation up and running. To measure the performance difference, we need a baseline measurement of the system we have at hand. Let's spawn a limited number of voids, say 2500 of them, and have them all rendered on screen, meaning we are going to move the camera and position it in a way that all 2500 voids are on screen and then take note of how many frames are rendered per second. I'm using URP and I'm getting around 450 FPS, jumping between high 300s to 450. Now let's disable the system, create a new C# script and copy the old code so we can modify it to use iJob entity batch. If you see, we have two for each loops which we want to move to batch job. The first loop is assigning a hash key to bucket the voids, while the second loop does all the calculations. I'm not going to go over the calculations here, it is very simple and you can watch my previous video or any other void simulation video. Let's do this in increments. Let's create the bucketing job first. We do this by creating a job, let's call it bucket voids, which implements iJob entity batch. Note that a lot of code has to be written here while using iJob entity batch compared to that of entities.foreach. We need the hash map to assign a hash key for a set of voids, along with voids themselves referred by void component data and their translation. We can pass this information using something called component type handle for all the components the job needs. This job is executed on chunks divided into batches of entities, and the execute is called for every batch. We need to get the component chunk from the current batch, which is the native array of component types ready to be processed. We now loop over the batch, which is a piece of chunk, and here is where we can copy the current logic. We are not done yet. We need to schedule the job by specifying an entity query to select the chunk our job needs. We can then schedule the jobs like we normally do, just the way we do with the job system, except for the fact that we can specify the batch size per chunk while scheduling the job. Let's test this and see if it is working. Alright, let's move on then. Let's remove the commented code and move the logic to calculate the capacity of hash map, as we have an entity query anyway. Let's write another job and I'll go over quickly now, as you might already guess how this is going to turn out. I did not want to copy all the fields individually while modifying the voids component. Also, note that it has to be a new void component data, as we cannot override the data we received directly, unlike the entity for each loop. It's the same thing, but here it is more explicit, I guess, whereas in for each it happens behind the scene. We can delete the old code and schedule the job. We can reuse the component type handle. We only need an additional rotation type handle and a new query with read-write on void component data. That is it. Now for the moment of truth. I have not changed these settings and let's run the simulation. Well, we are now getting around 250 to 300 FPS. This does not mean you should not be using iJob Entity Batch at all. Maybe the void simulation was a bad use case, or the way I had written the code was in a bad way. Anyway, the performance reduced in my case. Even if it did not, I would still suggest sticking with the cleaner and more efficient entities.foreach loop while working on dots projects. This is all I have for now. Thank you for watching and I'll see you in the next video. Have fun.